As announced in our earlier videos, we now explain how the required ballast is calculated for temporary demountable structures. Mark Hendricks has already explained that structures must be secured against overturning, sliding, and uplifting. Now we will talk about how to calculate the required ballast due to these effects. Let's start with a proof against uplifting. A roof structure that is closed on three sides will lift up when wind blows into the open side. As soon as the structure's self-weight is less than the uplifting force, the difference in mass must be added. The next proof refers to overturning. A structure is protected against overturning as soon as the standing moment is larger than the overturning moment. This principle is demonstrated on a truss frame that is stabilized by a base plate with a certain size and weight. The total of the horizontal force multiplied by its height is the overturning moment. The standing moment is the total of the self-weight and ballast multiplied by its lever arm to the overturning point. When these two expressions of overturning moment and standing moment are set equal, it can be rearranged to solve the equation for the required ballast. It should be noted that increasing the depth of the structure leads to a proportional decrease in the required ballast. The last effect is sliding. The difficulty of sliding two bodies against each other depends on the friction factor between them. Of course, it's easier to slide a concrete block over an icy surface than a rubber mat. Examples of different material combinations are listed in EN 13814. The required ballast is equal to the horizontal load divided by the friction factor. A wooden spreader plate on a concrete floor has a friction factor of 0.6, which requires a vertical load of 1667 kg to secure a horizontal load of 1000 kg. As stated in our previous video, the screw jack needs to be embedded in or bolted to the wood. Otherwise, an unfavorable friction factor of 0.4 between the steel-made screw jack and the wood applies, and the ballast increases to 2500 kg. As explained in the previous video, tower bases are subject to horizontal forces due to wind load and membrane forces, as well as vertical forces due to actual tower loads and tension forces from the guy wires. So the effects of uplifting, overturning, and sliding appear simultaneously and result in multidirectional forces that require a complex ballast calculation.